moving along, we got like so many more. Because look, these were downloaded on the 12th of January. I'm going back all the way to the 26th of December, son. As always, I should mention this in the beginning, not at the end. In the last one, I mentioned the timestamps were in the, now that you've watched the entire video, timestamps are in the description box. You're welcome. Timestamps are in the description box. They're cut off because I put the playlist link first, which I probably should change. But consistency. Nobody likes change. Why is a Bullet winning a Tager v Bullet matchup? It's one of the worst fucking matchups in the game. And she's winning? She should have lost. Like, off of that, I don't know why that Tager was so passive at the end of it. But off of that whiff, she basically should have been dead. That's a free. There's nothing Bullet can do on the way down that will protect her from 2C. One of the few scenarios where 2C would actually work. Might be the dude. Well, now he's dead. Why is a Bullet winning? Should never let Bullet win this matchup. Oh, they hit confirm. Counter hit JA into Grand Punish. Holy shit. That's still gonna put him in block stun. Okay, it doesn't matter. Not enough! If he had actually thrown out Spark Bolt, that would have hit. If the Bullet had held it, Spark Bolt would have hit the armor and she would have been fine. But since she didn't, that would have counter hit her. And Tager would have corner control right now instead of getting a knee to the chest. Should not have been hit by that. Well, that's interesting. That was one of those, like, time freeze rapid cancels. I've never actually seen that happen outside of Hakumen's counter. Where you throw out a rapid cancel, but the game actually, like, it's actually impossible to rapid cancel whatever you're doing. And so it doesn't take your meter, but it still says rapid cancel. So I was confused for a second about why they still got hit, because I saw the rapid clearly come out and I heard it. But then I glanced at the meter. She didn't really get it. The game's just a big fat liar. This should be it. Right here. It should be done. Unless you just don't tech and give Tager the corner for free and mash off a gadget finger with Bullet, who doesn't have a single good option at that range. What is happening? If that Bullet should have won. If this were a particularly good player, which, since they're picking Bullet, I have to assume they're not. No good player would deal with the bullshit Bullet has to deal with on a daily basis. I can definitively say this as a lifelong Tager player. If I was actually good, I wouldn't be using this character. Whiff punished that J2C, since they're in overdrive, it would have been an overdrive hit confirm. Tager would have been dead. Burst safe because they're in overdrive the entire time. That was their game. They handed it away. That was a bad sequence. Oh god, that made it an even worse sequence. Holy shit! Like, overdrive has introduced such a significant element of randomness to the game. That wasn't even a punish, they just got hit low. Surely they could have killed it off. Or they'll just throw out 236B and it'll work! Oh my god, it's Susanoo's thing. It's like I'm in high school again. It's so edgy! I actually never really listened to music. I used to listen to rock pretty much exclusively. That actually kind of ended around high school. It was in middle school that I was really into rock. And all of my friends thought I was weird because they were all rap fans. I was the only person that listened to rock in my entire group of friends. I was so lonely. I had nobody to discuss music with. punish. Oh, there we go. Okay, the projectiles got him. Should be it. Surely they... Oh, okay, they don't even need it. Because that was kind of like off the starter. It was kind of hitting a point where it felt like the combo might end prematurely at any point in time. So I was getting more and more surprised that I wasn't seeing a super. Oh, if they had just held it, they would have gotten Exceed Excel off of that. That's really all you can do with a move like that, because 6B, there's no gap in between that you can throw something out and beat it. Unless it's invincible, obviously. But that should have just been a held down Exceed Excel. That's what, the third air throw? I keep feeling like, I mean, I know that I'm not a particularly high level player, but I keep seeing combos where they're ended and the person has meter and they don't use that meter, and every single time I'm just, there's something inside of me that's screaming, surely there was a kill possible. Nice. I mean, they're getting all the meter they want, so it is actually nice. It just looks so weird. Like, with 5C? Yeah, I fuck it all overdrive. Can't believe that hit. The sword must have, like, barely tipped. Like, the tip of it. Clipped Naoto's arm when he extended to do that D move. You gotta keep holding it down until you're confirmed on the ground. That is also another, in case you are unaware. Ooh, that was a nice attempt to, I got two things to talk about. I'll actually pause this in between rounds. I'll hopefully try to remember. I'll know what the last one was, but I might have just forgotten what the first one was. Oh, shit. I did. I totally forgot what I was going to talk about initially. So, what actually happened there... Oh, the barrier. So, actually, it helps they use barrier. So the second thing that happened that I can remember very clearly, that rapid cancel into that rapid fire barrier was a very solid attempt to try and catch somebody who at that point would be like, oh, I'm gonna die from this, I need to burst out of this. And so somebody who was just, you know, thinking that I need to burst as soon as possible. So if they were actually mashing burst right there, they would have gotten that burst blocked and the Hakumi would have won the round. Unfortunately, I think they held, I can't actually remember at this point because I'm a terrible person, but I believe they held it a bit too long, and their attempted follow-up 5C whiffed. But then the second thing that I was going to talk about again in relation to barrier is one of the aspects of it is obviously you need it to block air unblockable moves. But when you block a move using barrier in the air, you stay in the air for longer. You don't keep dropping like you would if you had not used barrier. Well, obviously, if you had not used barrier, you can actually block that move. And so it gives people a lot of additional moves that they can use that are continuing to be air unblockable. And it actually, so like, for instance, against Tager, it's entirely possible, if you are barrier blocking everything he does, to basically put somebody into an inescapable Atomic Collider setup, because you're stuck there. You're stuck right where his palm would come up and grab you out of the air. And so it is kind of, you know, a danger there. But, I mean, obviously you have to, unless you want to just get hit. That's awkward start. Why would you hold bear? Like, at that range, Hakumen really doesn't have anything that's gonna bop you. That you would want to start a round like that. I think that is one of the things. There's not really something anybody ever practices, right? But, like, a lot of people are really bad at making a good choice right at the round start. You better not give this Hakumen a hit. That was actually a perfect opportunity for it. Yeah, it's... I mean, granted, I don't know. That was a terrible idea. What are you doing? Oh! But he didn't kill. That was death. That was absolute death right there. Now he's dead anyway. because since he's in Mugen and in Overdrive, you'll notice his meter doesn't go anywhere. If you use Mugen and you're in Overdrive, you can do whatever the fuck you... Oh, yeah, a Hakumen. I've been... Not a Hakumen, a Valkenhayn. I've been waiting for this. But yeah, so while you're basically the entire... In case you are unaware, when you are in Mugen, your meter declines at a steady rate. But while it is declining, you can use any move essentially at no cost. Any special move that would usually require meter, which gives him access to some really ridiculous combos. But if you are in Overdrive, it prevents that meter decay. You don't get any more, but it just freezes your meter right where it is. So for the entire duration of Overdrive, if you are in Mugen, you can do whatever the hell you want. And even then, you know, you still, depending on how much meter you had when you entered it, and obviously that person had all the goddamn meter, you have anywhere between like a second to maybe 4 or 5 after Overdrive ends where you're still in Mugen and still able to do whatever the hell you want. So, like, if a Hakumen doesn't kill you when they are in Mugen and they have Overdrive available, they suck. Pure and simple. You should be dead every single time if you ever get touched in a scenario like that. So show me. I am already skeptical, because that was some really suboptimal movement right there. That's dirty, though! Granted, he only gets about 2k off of it. That's a good burst. I actually 100% like that burst until that happened. But instead of giving Valkenhayn Oki, instead you pin them in the corner and you get to run pressure. Because Valkenhayn doesn't have it. There's nothing he can do defensively. He doesn't have any reversals. If that was a... I don't think that would have worked. Oh, wait, no. Is his 5A a low? Did it used to be? I think his only low now is like 2C or whatever that kind of tail whip thing is. I feel like that should have been confirmed. Did not look like that should have hit him. That little explosion. The sword obviously definitely clipped him. But the projectile hit him first, and that did not seem like something that should have. Good anti-air. Terrible confirm. I was so excited to see Valkenhayn, and honestly, I am unimpressed. Nice throw. Oh, that just sucks. Oh, that's what I was wondering. Are they going to be able to account for... Yeah. Like, this dude has setups that initially are like, oh shit, what's about to happen? And then he just does something that isn't really a mix-up. It doesn't take advantage of, like, whatever they just did that was impressive initially. There you go, an actual hit confirm. Until they dropped it. I really like that change, though. Being able to do that kick in the air and then follow it up by going into wolf form. I think that Valkenhayn got hit with every single projectile that got thrown out. Where's the other? I know I have 2 Valkenhayns in here. And I want to see the second one now. I apologize that I'm going to be taking up a little bit of your time additionally. Instead of just hopping straight into the next one. I told you, there it is. Told you I had a shitload of replays. I think I had gotten around... Because the last time I counted, I was at 82. And I, added like 5 or 6 since then. So the good thing... Unless people just completely stop caring about this series, as long as people still care about it, this is pretty much going on forever. The bad part is people definitely prefer me playing my own matches. That's not a bad part, but I think you get my drift. Oh, I just realized it's another goddamn S. It's the same matchup. Oh! That's the first time I've seen his new overhead in an actual match, and he just get punted out of it. God damn it. Because I believe that is hit confirmable if you immediately cancel into wolf form. Fuck! It's kind of hilarious. Like, any other character gets hit with a move that looks like that, you're thinking this person's about to eat 4K with S 2.5. It's actually not as devastating as you might have initially thought. That shouldn't have worked. This is a big flaw. Big, big flaw. It's really difficult to get around if you are a Valkenheim player. Is the movement. Because his movement is absolutely 100% his biggest asset. Just the fact that he can enter wolf form and be in your face instantaneously. But you have to know how to actually utilize it. Oops, my bad. To ensure that you go exactly where you want to. And so, like, right there, he just flew straight past S and got punched for it. That is definitely... It's a hard thing to do, because with a lot of characters, you kind of... People will practice defensive options, people will practice setups, combos, OP, all this kind of thing, but I do think one thing that's often overlooked is movement. I've certainly never worked on my movement, you all know that, because I suck at dashing still, let alone anything more complicated than that. It wasn't quite as dirty as I think it could have made it. Actually, I've never really been that impressed with 6C rapid stuff. 3C Rapid is where it's at. That is some dirty shit. Because you cannot block... You cannot block that reactively. You can react to it. But there is such a minuscule difference between putting out an overhead before you land after the Rapid Cancel or landing and throwing out 2A that... You don't get to react. You have to just guess. Maybe you could option select it. Like, just hold straight back for a tiny amount of time and then go straight down to down back. That was a good call out. Could have punished that if they attacked. This Azrael got figured out so hard in that round. Oh my god. It is every decision they made, they got called out on. The up back got thrown. Two back dashes got punished. Intentionally, like they kept, just they just dashed the entire way in. Oh, he almost did it. If he had grabbed again right there, I would have just turned it off. Wouldn't have even bothered watching the rest. Like, it's over. You figure a player out that hard, there's no coming back. Why would you not rapid cancel that? Now you're dead. Why are you not going into overdrive? That Ragna fucked up. Well, until Azrael fucked up. But that should have 100%. I mean, maybe they weren't paying attention to how much burst Azrael had back, which it's a very easy thing to do. It is so much easier to be an armchair warrior and notice things. So it's entirely possible that Ragnar just lost track and didn't realize that Azrael was about to get their burst back. But even then, even if they weren't about to get their burst back, that should have just been an immediate overdrive. Oh, this is the same Azrael? Could have been a whiff punish. That's a fairly riskless scenario to throw it out into, because if you press a normal, if the you're either in block stun, the normal doesn't come out and you're unaffected, or alternatively, they whiff that and then the normal comes out and you get a free whiff punish. What the fuck kind of mix-up was that, and why did it work? Rapid cancel dash through into five, like the rapid cancel dash through, that's some dirty shit that'll catch some people, but dash through into 5B. Action. I think I figured out why it worked. But I don't want to be mean. It's because these people aren't very good. It's definitely a lot more difficult to tell, to determine somebody's overall quality. If they had done Rekka's, I think they would have had corner, and they would have been able to do 2C. The hardest of callouts, and then they fucked up the potential punish. Yikes. But in terms of, like, because with Japanese arcades, there are so many matches played by so many people there. I mean, part of it is just you see familiar names and you know because of multiple games. Oh my god, that is an awful Naoto color. Because of multiple games, you know where somebody's generally at quality-wise. But even then, you can generally determine by rank how good somebody is. So if somebody has the yellow icon, they're pretty much like a tournament top 8 quality style. And then if they've still got a number, like they're level 20 to 25, they're pretty good, but they're just not quite at the high level stage yet. And then anything below that is kind of just like still learning and getting better. But online it's very different, because there have been some very bad level 30 plus people. Ooh, that has a lot of minimum damage in overdrive. This dude should definitely stick to Naoto. This is he plays Tager too. And I would, at least so far, from only one round, until that defensive thing right there where you just sit there and you hold barrier for 10 seconds. It's a little weird. But I like their Naoto better than their Tager so far. Until they did that. Why did that work? She was behind him. Oh my god, that hitbox. Oh, if that had actually comboed, I would have been pretty hype. Naoto's dash DP. Is that the best DP in the game? I have to imagine it is. At least invincibility-wise. In terms of what you get off of it, like the potential reward, it probably isn't. The wheel of fate is turning. Rebel, one. Action. This is going to be a wild match. That's actually why I downloaded this. I want to see, because this is two offensive powerhouses that are basically hopeless on defense. Good blocking by the Rachel. Right up until that point. Those weren't, you know, like unblockable level, but they were pretty tight. Got clipped by the instant overhead. If you didn't wear that silly ass hat, you might have been short enough to duck it. Oh, you cannot let that man roll out for free! Oh, you dead! Oh, you were soda! Oh, never mind. That wind is really difficult to adjust to for your setups. Fuck George. Oh man. They used to be a legitimate command grab. Now it's blockable. Oh, you are just... No, oh, that was smart. If they knew exactly what they were doing, that was mad. Because that's always hit oddly against airborne opponents. And you are basically considered airborne when you're on the ground like that. Is he? That was a lot more exciting than I thought it would be. I really liked that match. Because that was really back and forth. Like, the entire time. They both use their escape options well. They're both pretty solid on defense. And as everybody knows, their offense is among the dumbest in the game. That backdash! Ooh! Carl just made... Oh, man. If he had done that just... I think that was meant to combo. I think that's why there was a missed time right there. But yeah, if he had timed that just a fraction of a second later, that would have caught that wind usage. Oh my god! Carl! A nice back and forth match turned into the most one-sided display you ever done seen. Good lord, that character. That's not a good start. This is a really bad start. This S has not managed to block a single thing. Oh, that was actually kind of a bad, like, 3 meters off of a 5A hit confirmed, and yeah. Whoa, how did you, I think she was trying to jump out, it looked like? I don't know. She should not have been caught by that, though. Now's another time that I wish I could get that rewind, because I'm pretty sure he doesn't actually get a Magatama unless the counter activates. That would be really nice for him, though, if, like, against somebody that's just throwing projectiles at you, if you counter them and get a meter for each one. The momentum! Why does he like throwing out 6C randomly so much? Actually seems like it's worse to late tech that. Because it is fairly delayed in terms of its activation. So it kind of, you know, if you don't delay tech that. I guess it depends on the strength of the S's. Oki. Oh, you can't let a counter hit 6B go to waste, Hakuman, please. But an S can definitely put you in block stun off of an immediate wake up until that thing activates, but that S was kind of backing off and waiting for him to tech, which doesn't really help. You can't really do, these S's normals aren't the fastest in the world. So you could probably chicken block off of that and not have to deal with any potential instant overhead mix up off of it. But yeah, because he keeps delay teching. Oh my god. Hakuman, please. Work on your hit confirm. I mean, I know you won right there, but man, it was a lot closer than it should have been based on what hits you got. The Wheel of Fate is turning. Action! It's good to be patient, but not quite that patient. That's 0 for 2 on overhead attempts. That is a bummer. That's a huge bummer. Okay, never mind. That was a terrible setup. Confirm or deny, Naoto player's terrible combo? That was pretty dirty. That overhead was pretty much hidden by the animation. Nice. He has a really solid hitbox on his anti. I mean, anybody who has an anti that can hit behind them looks stupid, probably shouldn't happen, but you're in good goddamn shape. He wanted to bait out the DP, and he lost all of the momentum because of it. Son! Alright, maybe he didn't give it a... Yeah. Naoto players confirm. That should have been a kill. Why would you not barrier that? That was so much chip damage to eat. Like, now he's one yet. That was an unnecessary amount of chip damage to eat. Especially when it's that close at the end. Oh, the old zombie-ish color. It used to be good, and now it's not. Lock. You gotta do something there, man. It's what, negative 5 on block for 5D, right? Granted, you do have to be a little concerned with 5D delay cancel 236A. Alright, worked out. Oh man, that's when you know you gotta go back to the drawing board. If you ever let somebody wake up twice? That is such a huge weakness in this player's defense that people should be exploiting mercilessly. That he's very clearly just mashing throw on wake up. That was awkward. Only the highest level gameplay here on this channel. What the fuck? Oh my god. Only the best. Brought to you by Nate Aristotics. I don't watch these beforehand. I guess I want to be surprised by it. For analytical purposes, it would be better to kind of like watch them first and maybe, you know, like take notes and stuff like that. But I'm not trying to go that in depth. But matches like that are definitely the kind that I would just kind of be like, you know what? Let's just skip this one. The empty jumps! That was a mad slow one, too. He dead? I don't know the minimum damage on that. He dead. Ooh, that's a bummer. That was awkward all around. It was a little, he was pretty far away because of the barrier blocking that preceded the 5D. So I'm not actually sure if he could have done anything off of that. Ooh, ooh, no. Didn't have any meter to do anything after that. Thankfully, hit confirms off of that do approximately 1,000 damage. That is... Did they change the proration on that? Because that legitimately used to be like, oh, you hit me with that? 1.5k. How about that dude's just, like, he's literally block stringing the doll, and he just got a lucky antsier off of the 5A. Empty jump again! This dude is just getting stuffed left and right. You gotta work on your poke game, my man. He got double perfected in that. At least he won a round in between. I wish I'd do one more. Showdown between the big bads. I actually feel like Izanami would win this match. Because eventually she gets the armor available to her, and then she can just like walk through all of Nine's bullshit. Although I guess she is pretty free on defense, huh? So I guess that would be a solid kind of like 5-5 style matchup. Whoever gets the first hit tends to win. I actually, amusingly enough, I think this 9 would be better if they were less active. Not in general, but just the amount of slides that this Izanami player is throwing out, those are all punishable. Granted, they did have meters, so they could have rapid canceled them and then started going into pressure. They might have had some godlike plan that I was not aware of, but they were doing the same thing when they didn't have meter either, so it kind of feels like they're just hoping. And since all of those slides are very punishable, sometimes you should like kind of just abandon your offense and let somebody kill themselves. A lot of little things that, I think right there, I'm not actually 100% sure if that was a punish, but this Izanami has rolled forward after getting knocked down in the corner every single time. And that is something that she cannot let go unpunished. Rapid cancel. That was actually really, that armor was really well dealt with, and then they just gave it away at the end. You can't let that, you cannot let them get away with that, especially when they've been abusing it so much. That has to be expected at this point. That was interesting. Oh, it feels so bad, this 9. I mean, I don't know, maybe they'll pull it back, I don't know. But based on kind of like the level of play of both people, that 9 threw it away. That Izanami did not win. The 9 gave it away. That always hurts.